Hi, I'm Jacob Goede, a mechanical engineer with MTS. Today we're going to talk about the 261 Structure Pressure Test Controller, or SPTCs for short. We have three different models currently, the 261-01, the 261-04, and the 261-08. They all function very similarly, the main difference being the flow capacity of each one, with the 261-01 being the smallest and the 261-08 being the largest. So here's our 261-01 setup, and we'll kind of walk through the various components that make it work. So here we got supply coming in to the unit. It comes to the supply butterfly valve, and we also have an exhaust butterfly valve. So when the system is energized, the supply butterfly valve opens and the exhaust closes. Our controller is what's communicating to the proportional valve. So the proportional valve, based off the controller feedback, will send a air pressure signal to the booster valve. The booster valve then compares mechanically the structure pressure to the commanded pressure from the proportional valve. If there is a difference, it either depressurizes or pressurizes, depending on which way it needs to go. For small depressurization, we're going to flow out this muffler right here. Helps quiet the system down. If there is large command to depressurize, we got an additional auxiliary dump valve in the system, which we will talk about in a little bit. All right, so now that we got pressurized air going to the tank, as you can see, we're hooked up through hoses. Anytime you're flowing any type of media through hose, we have to be mindful of the diameter and the length. You can severely limit the performance of your system if you have excessively long hoses or really small diameter. So we got our tank set up over here. It's a 1.5 cubic meter tank, or 400 gallon. We got a pressure transducer installed, and we also have an auxiliary dump valve, which we will see in operation once we bring Mike to run the test for us.
Hi there, Michael Dembinski with MTS Systems. I'm going to talk a little bit more about how we actually control the SPTC for a pressurization test. As Jacob mentioned previously, we have a proportion air valve on there that we have linked to our FlexTest controller. We control this with a command plus feedback channel. It's a little different than your standard command minus feedback channel, because even when we reach the load that we're commanding to, in order to maintain that, we have to continue to output voltage to the valve. Since we have it as part of a FlexTest controller and we're controlling it with AeroPro, we're able to bring other things into our AeroPro test. Other things like actuators or other transducers, and they can all be a part of the same data stream. And because of that, we're able to synchronize both our pressurization and loading from other actuators all in just the same test. We also have access to all the same things that we get in AeroPro, like limit detectors that allow us to interlock the test if we need to. So we're going to be controlling the proportion air valve. In order to close it, we need a feedback signal. The feedback signal that we're using is our pressure transducer over on the vessel. Additionally, Jacob mentioned that we have an auxiliary dump valve. This dump valve is going to be controlled by a high-powered DIO from the FlexTest controller. We have some special logic in there to allow us to control the dump valve, open it when we want to, and close it when we want to, depending on the test or whether it's interlocked. So next, I think we're going to go ahead and actually load up the test and start pressurizing the vessel. All right, I've got the AeroPro test set up here. As I mentioned before, we're closing the loop on our pressure transducer. I've got a data display set up here as well. I've got two signals in this plot. One signal is the red signal, and that's our feedback. That's our pressure within the vessel. I've also got a green signal, and that's going to be our command, what we're telling it to be pressurized to at any given moment. So I'm going to go ahead and ramp this up so that it pressurizes to 15 psi, and then we'll go ahead and depressurize after that, and let's see how well we can do that. All right, so first I'm gonna go ahead and pressurize here. And now we're holding at 15 PSI within the tank. And next we will perform the dump. And the way that the dump is performed is we have some special calculations within our DIO to control the auxiliary dump valve and open it when we want to and close it when we need it closed. So that's gonna aid us in the depressurization of this vessel. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. So as you can see, it depressurized pretty fast, and that was from the aid of the dump valve. We don't quite have as much control in the depressurization as we do in the pressurization when we are depressurizing as fast as we are, really as quick as we can.